द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर गेट 2022 इंजीनियरिंग साइंसेज. सो इट इज़ गिवन दैट स्टीम एंटर्स अ स्टीम टर्बाइन एट 10 मेगा पास्कल एंड 600 डिग्री सेल्सियस विद अ मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ 16 किलोग्राम पर सेकेंड. सो वी स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चन. सो वी हैव अ स्टीम टर्बाइन. सो फॉर स्टेट वन इट इज़ गिवन 10 मेगा पास्कल एंड 600 डिग्री सेल्सियस विद ए मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ 16 किलोग्राम पर सेकेंड. द स्टीम एग्जिट्स द टर्बाइन एज सैचुरेटेड वेपर एट 10 किलो पास्कल. सो दैट इज डिनोटेड विद स्टेट टू एंड दिस इज सैचुरेटेड वेपर एट 10 किलो पास्कल. द टर्बाइन जनरेट 16.2 मेगावाट पावर. मीन्स दिस इज डब्ल्यू नॉट एस विच इज 16.2 मेगावाट. If the ambient temperature is 25 degree Celsius, so this is the ambient temperature which is 25 degree Celsius, the rate of entropy generation in the turbine is, so I have to find the rate of entropy generation, so neglecting change in kinetic and potential energies of the steam, and it is given the property table. So this question is similar to question number 107. In that question we have find irreversibility, but we have find entropy generation, not the rate of entropy generation, because in that question we have find S generation in kilojoule per kg, and in this question we have to find rate of entropy generation, means we have to find in kilowatt per Kelvin. So the first thing, this has to be clear. Now taking the turbine as a control volume, we will apply the entropy balance, that is m naught. Now we have to use m naught since we are finding rate. S2 minus of S1 is equal to Q naught by Ts plus S naught generation. Now this we have to find. This is the surrounding temperature. So in this case the ambient temperature and the immediate surrounding temperature of the turbine is same. So Ts in this case is T naught. Now we have to find Q naught since S2 and S1 can be found out from this table, because the condition of state is steam is clearly defined. So to find Q naught, we will apply steady flow energy equation. Since it is given, the turbine is under steady state condition. So applying a steady flow energy equation, which in short form I can write SFEE. So I can write Q naught plus sigma mi hi plus ci square by 2 plus gzi is equal to sigma me he plus ce square by 2 plus gze plus w naught s. See, please avoid shortcuts and write the complete equation, then mitigate that equation as per the assumptions given in the question. Now it is clearly given that we have to neglect change in kinetic and potential energies, so this goes to zero. And at the inlet stream, we have only one stream. Similarly, at the exit, we have only one stream. So I can write this as Q naught plus M1H1 is equal to M2H2 plus W naught S. The value of W naught S is 16.2 megawatt, which I have to convert in kilowatt. This is 16.2 into 1000 kilowatt. Now H1 can be taken from this table as, since turbine is under superheated condition, so I can write this H as 3625.34. So Q naught plus M1 is 16, 3625.34. Now M1 is equal to M2. If you apply mass balance across this control volume, then M1 is equal to M2. So this is 16. Now H2 is this 2584.63. So this question is quite simple because they have directly given the value of S2 as SG, so you need not to worry about SG and SF, plus 16,200. So solving this equation, we get Q0 as minus of 451.36 kilowatt. So this is in kilowatt, remember, by M1 is in kilogram per second, and H1 is in kilojoule per kg. So this get cancelled, you will get kilojoule per second, which is kilowatt. So the unit of Q is kilowatt. You can check from this equation as well. This I have to find in kilowatt per Kelvin, So this must be in kilowatt because this is in Kelvin. Now, using this equation again, we can write m naught S2 minus of S1 is equal to Q naught by TS plus S naught generation. Now S2 is the exit, means this is the value of S2, this is the value of S1. So I can write 16 into 8.1501 minus of 6.9018 is equal to 451.36 upon this is T naught, TS is equal to T naught, and this should be in Kelvin. So this would be 25 plus 273, which is equal to 298 Kelvin. So this is 298 Kelvin plus S naught generation. Now solving this equation, I will be getting S naught generation as 21.4 kilowatt per Kelvin. So this is the final answer. Remember, this should always be greater than zero. It can never be negative. If this is negative, then the process will not be feasible.